Good morning, YouTube. We're in the Jag. We're in California still, going to Monterey. My brother's driving. He's not going to say anything. First, we've got scheduled a test drive in a Maserati, or not a, yeah, Maserati. And I think we're driving the Gran Turismo, which is a gorgeous car. It looks pretty badass. Then, right after that, we have to drive over to the other side of town, and we're going to go drive a Ferrari Lusso, the GTC 4 Lusso T, which is the V8 with the twin turbos, not the V12. I'd rather drive the V12, but the Lusso T is still supposed to be pretty badass. I know it's a love or hate car. Some people hate the hatchback and they hate the four seats. After that, we're gonna try and go to the Porsche Works thing, and we got one or two other events, so it's a crazy busy day. We're gonna be exhausted. We're gonna suffer through all this torturing car stuff just for you. Halfway between Santa Cruz and Monterey, and it's kind of a foggy, shitty morning. We'll be seeing some crazy shit if it's anything like yesterday. Just about every supercar or hypercar you can imagine we saw yesterday. Pagani's, Ferraris, ridiculous numbers of Ferraris and Lamborghinis, every Porsche known to human race, including the 918, and two singers. That was badass. All right, what do you guys think of the Bentley, Bentayga, or how it's pronounced? Yeah, they're kind of like imposingly large. I don't know. I mean, you know my opinion. It's a ton of money for an SUV, and you know me, I hate SUVs, so I don't know, man. Some people like them, but it looks funky in my opinion. It looks kind of strange. I'm sure it's comfortable as hell and it rides like a dream, but 250 to 300 grand for an SUV? No thanks.
There it is. I think Bentley's connection. Some Bentley's
okay. To the front, ugh.
So perhaps one of the craziest things about this whole thing is just like, as we're driving, I love this car. As you're driving around, you just like see crazy shit everywhere. Going along, us, you're like, oh hey, look, there's a like there's a Rolls Royce. Oh, what the fuck is that thing? See, crazy shit everywhere. Like you can't go anywhere. Oh, what is that? What's that green guy?
It's an Audi R8.
Oh, it's a TTRS. Oh, only a TTRS. As David said, he's seen more supercars in one day. Oh, dude, the new Vantage. See what I'm talking about? Yeah, we saw more supercars and hypercars yesterday than we did in our entire life leading up to that point. You guys gotta go. You gotta go. This is amazing. Yep. See? 599. Gold wheels. Is it? Oh, is it? No, it's just a GTB. Okay, it's not a GTO.
It's only a GTB.
See, we're so spoiled now. We're laughing because a Portofino drove by and we're like, oh, it's just a Portofino. Yeah. Oh, this is so crazy, man. A couple cars in front of the 599 is another Bentley hiding behind all the giant. Yeah, McLaren just went by.
356. Yeah, there we go.
Damn, he's hauling. Yeah, that sounds good, man. That sounded great. 488. See, it's not quite the great, like, the sound of the 488 is just not quite as good as the 458.
Well, apparently that's where Bonham's auction is.
Oh, yeah. I'm gonna have to take the red, dude. I'm sorry. What was the horsepower? 454. Is my 490. Yeah, and he said it, so apparently this has the same block as my car, which is pretty cool. That's really fascinating. So, but it's a 4.7, so I'm assuming it's gotta be stroke.
It's really fascinating, so the alternator is up top and mine's down on the bottom.
It's like right in the middle of it.
Yeah, they put the alternator right in the V, in the valley.
Yeah, you can, you can tell the heads are even similar design, how they're shaped.
Yours is a little louder though, right? Obviously.
Yeah. Well, mine's loud as shit.
That thing sounded like it was the world's coming up.
Oh,
The 430s and the 458s.
Yeah.
So that also has the twin turbo V8. Okay, so this, yeah. This has the V8 twin turbo that's in the... The Portofino and the California. It's in the Portofino too now, right?
Same
one? Okay. Yeah. Jeez.
So it is a monster.
Yeah, like crammed in the turbos down there.
So they bring this one up to 550, and then our Trofeo that's at the Quill, 590. So what's cool about the Trofeo is that this all goes away, and then this block right here is all carbon fiber.
Oh, nice.
Gorgeous.
Yeah, it makes it nice and sexy. God. Holy crap. Those are pretty big.
Got to see, the seats look comfy.
This is what's worth driving, let me tell you. The carbon fiber, look how nice it looks.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah, that's the way to go. Maserati makes beautiful cars, man. And these sound so damn good. Just little details like that to make it beautiful. I got all the good stuff of Ferrari, but with more cushy, like, comfortable.
More of a daily driver.
Right, right, way more daily drivable.
Let's be real. I know you can daily drive 488 or whatever, but...
Good luck. Yeah, yeah.
It's comfortable, that's why they
buy it. Yeah, I was saying the seats in this are... The seats are really comfortable.
It's got something.
Oh, yeah, well, it's about the same as the Jag, yeah. Yeah, so without the drop top, you know.
Yeah, you have a little more added space to it.
Yeah. I had no idea that Pininfarina did these.
Oh, yeah, that's Pininfarina design.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Pininfarina. Oh, really? They did design?
Yeah, I didn't know that.
Go ahead. Yeah, go ahead and start it up and hear it.
Oh, dude. You see it raise the air suspension?
Yeah, because when you come in, when you stop, it gives you the entry exit level.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, there's a lot of room back here. He said the Gran Turismo, probably about 140, right?
140, 135.
135, 140, yeah. And then those ones right there, about 150.
Yes,
exactly. Spec'd out that way. And if you get the MC, it's all the way up to about 160, 170. 50, dude, they have the 5,500 pound towing capacity.
Really?
Yeah. Dude, I know, I was like, dude, haul our race car.
Wow. You have like a radical or something.
Well, yeah, I'd be right at the limit.
So we're in the Levante. This has the V8 twin turbo out of the Portofino, California. He says 550.
550 horsepower.
Jeez.
You can tell, I mean, I've been doing instructing and doing these programs and stuff close to 20 years. And it's funny how from experience we will go straight.
Okay.
We're able to really determine, right? Who's a good, safe driver that knows what they're doing behind the wheel and the ones that don't.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, it's incredible.
The first thing you always do is look at how they hold the wheel.
Sitting position.
Yeah,
sitting position
and wheel.
That's the first thing. When you see a guy that goes all the way back and starts, trying to get a cool.
Yeah, the one arm.
South
one
Beach. Arm. Yeah. I'm like, oh my God. Or the guys that come to a ride and drive test drive with racing boots and gloves. I'm like, really, dude? You're gonna be in a parking lot, man.
That is much faster than I expected. And it's pretty badass, actually.
Dude, when you stomp it and the turbo spin up, it's pretty good.
And the sound is really good, too.
Yeah, you can see where it's got the flaps and the cooling. The camera right there for the bird's eye view. Dude, I love the giant Maserati logo. That is bad.
That was a riot. That was good. And they have food too and drinks. This is great. The GT, the Gran Turismo is badass. The sound it makes is incredible. The ride is great. It's really comfortable. It's got the same engine block as my car, so automatically it's badass, right? The crazy thing is the Levante. What is the GTS? I think it's Levante GTS. With the twin turbo V8, hauls fucking ass. It scoots so fast. I am totally blown away. Way faster than you think is possible in a giant SUV like that. And I'll admit, it actually looks pretty good for an SUV, and it was really comfortable. So I'll give Maserati, like, good job, well done. If you need a really fast, badass SUV, probably should be looking at Levante. I think they said they come out with a new Gran Turismo very soon, so that'll be really interesting. It should, I mean, it's Maserati, it's gonna look great. Next up, we're going to go to Ferrari and test drive a GTC4 Lusso T. So it's not the V12, it's the V8 twin turbo, but it's still the four-seat hatchback Ferrari. Sat in the Lusso, and it's really comfortable, really nice. It's a pretty impressive Ferrari, so it's been my first time driving one, though. It's supposed to be really, really badass, so can't wait. Let's go check that out. We're at the Ferrari location. Parking's a bit of a cluster, but I gotta change the battery real quick, and then we're gonna go drive some Lussos. That's right, we're awesome. Midwesterners are the best.
Chicago.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Man, born and raised.
What? My sister still lives there.
You know
what's crazy? That's the first Portofino I've seen in Rosa Corsa. Huh. It actually looks really, really good.
So normally I would say pick your color, but
you get
yourself.
We get,
the color.
Is it Rosa Mugello?
I can tell you exactly what it is.
Looks like it.
Rosa California.
Rosa California, not Mugello. Okay. Carbon ceramics. I gotta get in first, I guess. To get in the back. Yeah, yeah.
So are you a Porsche fan or a GMG fan or?
Both. I have a Panamera Sport Turismo.
Okay.
The wagon. So that's probably the closest.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I'm not that far off of this yet.
Yeah, yeah. He's trying to convert me.
Yes, come to the red side. Yeah, it's a twin turbo, yeah, for sure. And you can still throw the kids in there and get groceries.
Come on, Dave. You know you want to come to the Ferrari world.
Maybe.
Yeah, this is a damn good car.
Okay, got done with the Lusso T. Pretty badass car. It really, really gets going. Turbo almost has no lag whatsoever. Shifts are super fast. Handling was excellent. It's a really, really good car. I know a lot of people don't like the hatchback design or the four seat thing, but pretty badass. So I don't know, man. If you have kids, that might be the way to go instead of the California. The Lusso T is a lot cheaper than the Lusso, because you only have the V8, not the V12. Anyway, so we're on to another thing. Gotta figure out what we're gonna do, but something. We're gonna do something.
But I'm like, that is a pretty fucking amazing car.
Oh my God, I got David to admit a Ferrari is amazing.
takes something to build a station wagon.
Yeah, it takes a wagon to convince Dave that Ferraris are good.
Put the top down?
Yeah, might as well. We're gonna be in slow traffic anyway. Might as well do it up. We're in California, let's live it up with some drop top action. Oh, you know what we could do? Could go try and get lunch somewhere.
Oh yeah,
let's go do that. All right, lunch.
I hammer it 100% almost every fucking time.
Oh, because it just punches you in the butt.
Because it doesn't make any noise, and so you just fucking do it. Because you're just like, you can hammer from a stoplight, and nobody thinks anything of it because they don't hear anything. But you fucking take off like pretty fucking fast. Where like even in this, if you don't even hammer it, people are like, asshole. You know what I mean?
We're joking that this car easily gets your ass in trouble because the sound, like, you just constantly want to see you want to do that everywhere you go, and of course everyone would be like, fucking asshole. Oh my God, we can't stop fucking laughing and smiling in this car. It's just unbelievable. Listen to this thing. God, what a riot, man. Look at his smiles. Just, oh my God.
Jaguar has gone up.
Yeah.
Another notch, or a new notch. I don't know.
Yeah. This is so impressive. I'm falling in love with this car. I thought running this car, we were gonna be like, it's okay. How fucking funny is this? So while we were driving, we saw another Jag convertible. Oh, 720. I like that color. Yeah, that's a really good color. So we're driving along and we see another Jag convertible and we waved at them. It turns out it's fucking Chris going the other way because he rented one of these too. So he called me, he's like, was that you? And I'm like, oh shit, that was you. We're onwards to go to the Porsche Works event, which should have obviously just a couple Porsches, like at least two. Jesus Christ. This fucking car. Another McLaren. Oh, I like the paint. It's got this orange paint. Yeah, that's nice. And a Ferrari.
Oh!
There we go. get so spoiled here. It's just, so we've seen a Centenario, we've seen Bugatti Chiron, we saw the, what is it, the EB11 or EB whatever it's called, that crazy, crazy one. Monterey is the Super Bowl of, it's Carchella. This is Carchella.
Ready?
Now here we go, I got the... I knew it was out here. I didn't realize it was like right there. That's Laguna Seca, like over the hills. That's crazy. Well, we may have hit a snag. Well, we've been sitting for about 3, 4, 5 minutes, something like that. And now we're barely moving, so. The shitty part is we're only like 1.5 miles from where we're supposed to go. This is beautiful. Look at this. Fucking crazy. My stupid YouTube channel. Good God Almighty.
California!
Yes!
Woo!
This is Neil. He's the guy who actually built the damn thing.
I think of all the crazy, crazy cars, the Pagani and the Koenigsegg.
So we're at this crazy Lamborghini party. You guys have heard of the Lamborghini Aventador SVJ? That's it, right behind me.